you guys know that Taiwan is the first country in Asia to legalize the same-sex marriage?
Really?
Yes, let me tell you it. In 2019, Taiwan became the first country in Asia to legalize the same-sex marriage. But
does Taiwan same-sex marriage really uphold homosexual rights?
And this is our table of content. The first part that we're going to talk about is our introduction.
Nowadays, the recognition of homosexual community in our society is gradually accepted by the public. However, there are still many people who don't agree on homosexual marriage as the awareness of the human right is raising. On May 24, 2019, Taiwan became the first country in Asia to legalize the same-sex marriage. And according to the Ministry of Interior, more than 2,000 same-sex couples have been married in Taiwan. However, does it really protect the right of the homosexual communities?
I guess you guys may wonder how we use our research method. Well, in order to gain a deeper understanding of Taiwan's same-sex marriage and its impact on Taiwanese, we divided a survey into two parts, literature review and an online questionnaire. The following are questions we would like to explore. First, why could Taiwan be the first country in Asia to legalize the same-sex marriage? Second, what are the opinions of homosexual community and public about the same-sex marriage? Third, are there any differences in civil code between heterosexual marriage and same-sex marriage?
First, why could Taiwan be the first country in Asia to legalize same-sex marriage? Over the past decade, Taiwan was only influenced by the Western culture. In this democratic country, freedom of expression and association now the facilitate process of the legalization but make the public more aware of the same-sex marriage issue. In addition, in this new generation, more and more citizens have the willingness to attend social movements. Their attention on low social issues indirectly affect the government decision and make this issue the main focus in current society as well. Second, what are the opinions of homosexual community and the public about the same-sex marriage? To the LGBTQ community, the legalization of same-sex marriage in 2019 is a significant turning point. Even if the Exclusive Act is still not perfect enough, they will continue fight for this permanent work. As for the public, it seems that the youth have more tendency to accept the same-sex marriage rather than citizens aged over 40. In their opinion, everyone is deserved to be loved, no matter what their gender or sexual orientation may be. Similarly, none of us need to be taught how to love.
And next, I will be talking about our third question. Are there any differences in the civil code between heterosexual marriage and same-sex marriage? According to the law, same-sex marriage is an exclusively established law. However, what are the differences between civil code and same-sex marriage? There are some organized points from the literature.
The first issue is international marriage. If Taiwanese homosexual want to get married with foreign partner, both countries need to accept a same-sex marriage. This will cause some inconvenience for them. For instance, if their foreign partner's hometown hasn't legalized the same-sex marriage, they would not be able to stay in Taiwan for good and have to spend quite a lot of money on plane tickets because of the restriction of resident visa. Now, let's take a story about Mr. Ding and Mr. Liang, for example. Mr. Liang came from Macau, and Mr. Ding is a Taiwanese. In the beginning, they spent almost all their salaries and savings on plane tickets just to meet each other regularly. They used to expect to get married in Taiwan after legalization. However, their dream hasn't been realized due to the limitations of laws and regulations regarding Hong Kong and Macau affairs. To perfect the act, Taiwanese government has passed the draft bill that allows Taiwanese homosexuals to get married with same-sex partners from different countries, except for China, not including Hong Kong and Macau, on January 22, 2021. It's hoped that international same-sex marriage in Taiwan will one day break free from limits in the near future. Same-sex couples also encounter another challenge, that is, children adoption. According to civil code, a husband and a wife can adopt children together. However, homosexual law only allows same-sex spouses to adopt biological children. Isn't it an impossible task? Now that surrogate mothers are still illegal in Taiwan, how could an LGBTQ couple have their own children? Those questions indicate that there are still a long way to go to achieve true equality.
Next, I will be talking about our findings. We used questionnaire to collect our research data. It took us a week to build the structure of our questionnaire. On May 26, 2020, we started to share our questionnaire on the internet, and the deadline of this questionnaire is June 6, 2020. During the phase of investigation, we have received 170 questionnaires. We divided our questionnaire into two parts. First is our participants' personal information and their factors that affect their judgment on the same-sex marriage issues. Now, let's move on to section one. First is their sexual orientation. As you can see, most of them are heterosexual. Next will be their ages. As you can see, most of them are age under 16. Now, section two is the question that we ask our participants. First, do you support the legalization of same-sex marriage? As you can see, most of our participants support the legalization. Next will be the reason why they agree with the legalization. Well, as you can see, people think that the law should ensure the right to marry, while some people think that everyone has an equal right to choose their partner. Next will be the reason why they disagree with the legalization. As you can see, people think that same-sex marriage is a violation against ethics, while there's still some other people think that same-sex couples are unable to bear the next generation. Now, question two. Do you agree the inclusion of same-sex marriage issues into teaching materials? As you can see, most of our participants support the inclusion, and they think we should include the same-sex marriage issues into junior high school phase. And that is all for our findings.
And last part, we will be talking about as conclusion and suggestion. In conclusion, Taiwan is the first country in Asia to legalize the same-sex marriage. But there is still some room for improvement, such as international marriage and children adoption. We think all are equal before the law and are entitled without any discrimination to protection of the law, no matter what their sexual orientation is. And from our research, we discovered that more and more Taiwanese people have more tendency to accept the same-sex marriage issue. And most of our participants think that we should include the same-sex marriage issue into junior high school phase. Also, we discovered that the reason why people agree and disagree on the issues.
In addition to conclusion, there are a few suggestions that we would like to propose for further research. First, in-depth interview with homosexual and the expert should be conducted to complete the representativeness of the research data. Second, the rights of homosexual community in the prison study didn't cover the issues of medical care. Therefore, it is hoped that the future research will take into consideration to make the outline of the data more crystal clear. Next, since same-sex marriage issues into teaching materials on the questionnaire have been widely supported, therefore, it is worth investigating and should be considered another group of research.
Regardless, being a bird is not easy. But if we could set an example for other Asian countries and show them how important the same-sex marriage is.
Meanwhile, reducing discrimination and showing more respect to the others, I believe we can make this world a better place. If you want to know more about our research, this is our references. Thank you.